So, Planetary Protection Officer, that's been in the news a lot lately, and let's see why. Hey, welcome to I Need More Space, the show brought to you by somebody that is not a Guardian of the Galaxy. I'll get to that in a minute. So, yeah, Planetary Protection Officer. It's a role NASA's looking to fill, and they dropped the job posting, I believe, last week. And it sounds really badass, but what exactly do they do? Well, luckily, that's something I'm here to help answer with the help of 9-year-old Jack Davis and Dr. Green from NASA. They've come in today to tell their stories. Jack applied for the job, and he's willing to read his cover letter to us. And Dr. Green is here as well to give us his response. Dear NASA, my name is Jack Davis, and I would like to apply for the Planetary Protection Officer job. I may be 9, but I think I would be a good fit for the job. One of the reasons is my sister says I'm an alien. Also, I have seen almost all of the space and alien movies I can see. I've also seen the show Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and hope to see the movie Men in Black. I am great at video games. I am young, so I can learn to think like an alien. Sincerely, Jack Davis, Guardian of the Galaxy, 4th grade. Dear Jack, I hear you're a Guardian of the Galaxy and that you're interested in being a NASA Planetary Protection Officer. That's great! Our Planetary Protection Officer position is really cool and is really important work. It's about protecting Earth from tiny microbes when we bring back samples from the moon, asteroids, and Mars. It's also about protecting other planets and moons from our germs as we responsibly explore the solar system. We hope to see you here at NASA one of these days. Sincerely, Dr. James L. Green, Director, Planetary Science Division. Alright, so now you've seen my horrible impression abilities. I'm probably not going to be doing that a lot on this channel. So, Dr. Green did a great job explaining, you know, the bare bones of like what a Planetary Protection Officer is. But to dig more deeply into it, they really have two main purposes. To make sure that when we send objects out into space, that they're not carrying any microorganisms with them. These spacecraft are just absolutely riddled with sensors, and they're measuring all kinds of information and data to send back to Earth. But if there are microorganisms on board the spacecraft from Earth, it's going to contaminate the samples. It's like you're baking a chocolate cake, but somebody drops sprinkles in the batter. Now it's, yeah, it's chocolate cake, but it also tastes like funfetti, and that's very confusing when we were just looking for chocolate cake. We also want to protect wherever we're going. So when we have landers coming to faraway places, we don't want them to come with any other organisms that may damage the ecosystem of that planet with microorganisms that it's never seen before. Okay, while I was editing the story, I realized I forgot the second half of the job. It's basically for them to make sure that no space cooties come back to Earth that can harm us. We saw this happening a lot in Apollo for the first few missions. Scientists didn't really know what to expect from the moon, but after several missions, they found out there were no space cooties and didn't have to worry about it. So yeah, it makes a lot of sense. With NASA's exploration schedule only growing by the year, they need to stay on top of this. There's a lot of satellites. They're being built all over the country, sometimes all over the world. Okay, guys, well, thanks a lot for watching. I reached 30 subscribers, so I'm kind of a big deal now. But if you're watching this and you're new, please subscribe to this channel. I really want to keep making videos. And I'm only really going to do it if there's people there that want to see them. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. Say hi to me in the comments if you're here. I promise to respond, and I'll catch you later. Thanks.
Okay, so I just realized that my screen was off for a little while, so I'm sorry about that. And I'm still getting used to this whole YouTube thing.